are the pulmonology team of Sarvodaya Hospital, Sector 8, Faridabad. Today we'll be demonstrating a very important module, which is removal of the personal protective equipment, which is also called as the doffing procedure. We will also be demonstrating the most contaminated areas and how by step we will be able to decontaminate ourselves. So first we will demonstrate the most contaminated areas after we use the PPE. The number one is the front of the gloves, the front of the face shield, the front of the mask, and the front of the gown. If we are wearing sleeves, then the sleeves are also most contaminated areas. Therefore, most care should be taken while we deglove or remove these contaminated surfaces. Now, the least contaminated areas would naturally be the back of the gloves. Now we will first demonstrate how to remove the gloves. So the first step is pinch the cuff of one sleeve and deglove it or peel it off. Now while peeling it off, try to make it into a small ball and put it in the other gloved hand. Now with the help of the index finger of the degloved hand, put it underneath the cuff of the glove and peel it off. And now put it in the bin. Once the gloves are removed, we need to perform the hand hygiene with the help of a sanitizer. Now we will remove the face shield. So to remove the face shield, we need to touch the non-contaminated surface, that is the back, which is the strap of the face shield. Gently pull the strap and remove it and discard it in the bin. Similarly, to remove the goggles, we need to touch only the strap of the goggles as demonstrated and then pull it out and discard it in the bin. After removing the face shield and the gloves, it's advisable to do hand hygiene as demonstrated. Now we'll be showing how to remove the gown. So we need to touch the most uncontaminated part of the gown, which is the backside, that is the straps or the ties, whichever is available. We'll like to remove or untie the gown as shown without touching any other surface. Now, since our gown has a elastic cuff, so what we need to do is put a finger inside the under surface of the gown without touching the contaminated areas and try to pull on the sleeves so that, and now with the gentle motion of the shoulders, try to wriggle yourself out of the gown. And while we do so, we'd like to make the gown into a small ball with the inner surface out and discard it in the bin. Once we do that, we would like to perform the hand hygiene again. Once the hand hygiene is done, we would like to remove the shoe sleeves. Again, we need to put a finger inside the under surface and gently peel it off. We should always ensure that the contaminated surfaces should not be touched. Now we'll be demonstrating how to remove the face mask. So to remove the face mask, as demonstrated, the lower strap should be removed first, pulled forward and left. Similarly, the other strap should be pulled and the mask should be directly put in the bin without touching any surface. After this, we need to remove the cap. So to remove the cap, again, we touch only the cap from the behind, insert the finger and just peel it off and put it in the bin. Once the entire PPE is removed, it is very important to perform hand hygiene for at least 20 seconds. All the steps are very important. After completion of each step,
one should ensure that proper hand hygiene should be done. This is how we perform the doffing procedure. Lastly, I would like to re-emphasize that any surface or material that is known or potentially which can be contaminated by a biological agent during lab operations must be correctly disinfected to control the infection risk. Also, proper process for the identification and segregation of all the contaminated materials must be done. Thank you.